following is a presentation of HBO Sports.
El ganador de esta pelea por decisión unánime, esquina azul.
Of all the never-ending stories that embody the Mexican nation and its people, there is no tradition as deeply embedded here as this one. Nothing else evokes as much history, inspires as much pride, and fuses so perfectly the notions of where they're from and who they are into one. So this is Mexico, and they are fighters. The tale of the red-headed boy born in the city of Guadalajara has already ascended into national legend. He followed his older brother into the boxing ring and discovered a preternatural gift for the craft, soon emerging as the country's next great hope. And then, the proud world champion, known simply, even regally, as Canelo. The legend of his name preceded his very existence, thanks to a father who epitomized everything Mexico reveres about its fighters. But if being born into boxing could have been a burden, Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. has always seemed at ease with his fate. At home with the notion that his feats could thrill and delight his countrymen. In so many other places, they might get lost in a sea of sporting heroes. But here in Mexico, fighters stand apart. They're carriers of a history dating back not just generations, but centuries. And that makes their bout, on May 6th, not just a clash, but a celebration. Not just a collision, but the continuation of a story that will persevere long after the sound of any bell. So they are Mexico, and this is its fighting tradition. At the height of the Aztec Empire, in the middle of the last millennium, a warrior's directive was holy and unequivocal. Capture the enemy and sacrifice them to the gods. In modern times, the nation that's risen atop the ruins of that ancient civilization may look to its warriors for more symbolic inspiration. But there is a sanctity that endures to their pursuit. The expectation that every time a fighter like Canelo Alvarez steps into the ring, he's representing his people to any number of deities judging from above.
Somos valientes, tenemos un estilo obviamente fuerte, un estilo aguerrido, un estilo que da grandes peleas, y creo que esas son las cualidades, no más que nada que tenemos muchos pantalones.
Las siete, sí, hay que hacer.
Pum, 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 pam, pam.
Ahí está.
The fighting tradition in Mexico, I mean, you go back many, many decades. I remember my grandfather, for instance, who was an actual fighter, would tell me these stories of how he would fight in the streets with boxing gloves for pride and no money at all. You're born with boxing running through your veins.
Cuando sabes que va a pelear un peleador mexicano, es sinónimo de una guerra arriba del cuadrilátero. El boxeo para México, yo creo que es lo que más le ha dado a México. Le ha dado grandes glorias el boxeo.
At age 26, he of the freckled face and cinnamon-tinged hair has become the latest personification of all that glory. The youngest of seven brothers from this small town, Guanacatlan, just outside of Guadalajara.
Yo empecé en el boxeo no porque veía el boxeo o admiraba a algún boxeador, no. Yo empecé por mi hermano más grande, fue el que lo vi debutar profesional y fue como inicié el boxeo.
All these years later, his gifts have made him a superstar in Mexico and beyond.
From Guadalajara, Saúl Canelo.
Right hand shot by Canelo, and Canelo can't miss. The curtains are closing. Alvarez landing everything. This is target practice. There's a perfect straight right hand. What a performance by Canelo Alvarez.
The May 6th bout with Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. will be the 51st of Canelo's career. A career highlighted by a 48-1-1 record, three world titles, and then also distinctions of the immeasurable variety.
It's Canelo's time, and you can see that when you go inside these gyms and you ask these kids, who do you want to be like? And the only word they can think about is, I want to be like Canelo.
They say that about Canelo now, just like others before them said it about the hallowed legends who preceded him. Men like Carlos Zárate, who in the 1970s epitomized the Mexican fighting style. As one of two boxers in history to put together two streaks of 20 or more knockouts in a row.
Bueno, yo me convertí en boxeador porque desde muy pequeño me gustó el box. Para mí era un juego pelearme. Yo me peleaba en la calle, en la escuela. El boxeo para mí significaba una emoción muy, muy, muy hermosa, muy bonita. Estoy orgulloso de haber representado a mi país en muchas partes del mundo.
If the memories that endure are in large part visceral, there's also immense satisfaction in being a member of the most celebrated cohort in the land.
Los mejores, Carlos Zárate. No, no ha habido muchos, ha habido muchos peleadores. Infinidad, hemos tenido más de 125 campeones mundiales, entonces es difícil comparar, pero creo yo que Julio César Chávez ha ganado más peleado más y creo que por eso es el número uno de los campeones en México.
Indeed, to understand why a fight pitting Canelo Alvarez against the son of Julio César Chávez is such an event in Mexico, one must consider the unmatched legacy of Chávez Sr.
Pero lógicamente siempre admiré a casi todos los boxeadores que fueron campeones del mundo, Zárate, Zamora, Olivares, Salvador Sánchez. Lo miraba pelear y decía, oh, increíble. Me coroné campeón del mundo en el 84. Y de ahí me fui.
Chávez would eventually win world titles in three different weight classes and legendarily win the first 87 bouts of his career.
That's it, you threw the towel in. It's over.
As an unrelenting force of nature who at his peak in the late 80s and early 90s was the best pound-for-pound fighter in the world. Revered, even worshipped by millions of Mexicans.
Y Julio César Chávez me inspiraba, ¿por qué? Por su boxeo, cómo peleaba. Es uno de los más grandes de México. Lo admiraba y lo sigo admirando, ¿no? Como lo que fue como peleador.
I actually remember my father taking me to Julio César Chávez's fights as a kid. Chávez Sr. to us was you know, that iconic figure that, you know, that everybody, every fighter wanted to be like.
So on the night of June 7th, 1996, Oscar De La Hoya found himself in an unenviable position, going toe-to-toe in the ring with his aging hero.
And now more blood as De La Hoya again lands with the right, and Chávez is already starting to flow above the left thigh.
Having to separate my feelings and my job, what I have to do, was very, very difficult. But I'm a fighter myself, and I had to take care of business. That was the bottom line.
That's it. He's calling the fight.
That's it.
The fight is over.
The De La Hoya bout was the first time Chávez was ever stopped before the final bell could sound. And 2 years later, a rematch ended in another De La Hoya victory. Still, those losses and the two decades that have passed since have done little to diminish Chávez's stature.
He gave hope to a whole country every time he would step inside the ring. And till this day, he is my hero. Till this day, I admire him, I look up to him, because he has done so much for Mexican boxing.
Cuando, pues, cuando yo estaba chico, creo que no entendía también lo que mi papá representaba para México. Bueno, es algo con que yo me sentí orgulloso, pero a la vez fue algo difícil con lo que yo viví. Entonces siempre he vivido con esa historia, pero gracias a Dios he hecho mis propias cosas.
Damas y caballeros de Culiacán, México, the undefeated Julio César Chávez Jr.
Cuando mi hijo me pidió pelear, yo le dije que no. ¿Por qué? Porque mi hijo no tenía necesidad de pelear. Pero al ver a mi hijo, que siempre andaba conmigo pegado de chiquito, se ponía los guantes, se me hizo muy difícil para mí decirle a Julio, mi hijo, que no peleara. Le dije, ¿sabes qué, hijo? Está bien, te voy a dar chance a 10 peleas para que hagas 10 peleas. Si pierdes una, te retiras. Y gracias a Dios, pues ganó las 10 peleas y siguió peleando.
Julio César Chávez Jr.'s early career success more than a decade ago was all the more impressive considering it came under the undeniable spotlight generated by his name and bloodline.
That was the Julio César Chávez trademark.
Though along the way, he was often reminded of a harsh reality.
Where do you think he learned it?
From watching his dad's film, probably more so, yeah.
Fair or not, that is the namesake of a boxing legend, comparisons to his famous father were inescapable, as were the reminders of how hard it would be to reach the same rarefied air.
Mira, para mi hijo Julio siempre ha sido muy difícil. Siempre querían que Julio fuera como su papá. Pero nadie va a ser como yo, ¿me entiendes? Ningún mexicano ha sido como yo.
An amazing display of power punching by Julio César Chávez.
Sí, bueno, la gente ha esperado mucho de mí.
y siempre va a seguir esperando más, porque no, es muy difícil ser igual que él, pero creo que he hecho más de lo que la gente pensó en un principio que yo iba a hacer. Cuando he hecho las cosas con ganas, me han salido bien. Cuando no las he hecho bien, los resultados se han visto.
And over the past few years, what hasn't gone well can't be attributed to merely not living up to his father's legacy. The self-inflicted damage has ranged from a suspension for marijuana use, to poor training habits, to problems with his weight, along with periods of inactivity. All contributing to a pair of defeats and lackluster performances even in victory.
Bueno, mi papá se sintió frustrado, más que nada porque él cree que yo hubiera podido hacerlo de otra manera.
Inclusive yo lo he criticado en la televisión y se lo he dicho a él personalmente, que no estaba de acuerdo cómo entrenaba, haciendo lo que él quisiera, entonces entrenando a la hora que él quiere, corriendo a la hora que él quiere. Y sí, tuvimos nuestras diferencias. Las derrotas que ha tenido mi hijo Julio han sido por su indisciplina. Y es por eso que la gente pues tiene sus dudas y tiene razón, ¿me entiendes?
Now, more than 10,000 feet above sea level, in the mountains west of Mexico City, Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. is looking to regain his footing as he prepares for the biggest fight of his career.
Hey, give box.
And to help him find his way, he's enlisted one of Mexico's most iconic trainers.
Todo es un movimiento de cintura, pero tus manos arriba para que las bajas.
A veteran of nearly six decades in the sport, Ignacio Nacho Beristain has monitored his latest pupil's highs and lows for years.
Es gancho, upper gancho, pero tienes que mover los hombros y vas a ver la diferencia.
Bueno, en un principio lo conozco desde niño. Siempre he pensado que es un muchacho con muchas facultades y que necesita ponerle atención, vocación a su carrera para retomarla.
Yo quiero que haga cintura, 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 que no le peguen. Me dice, yo aguanto. Digo, no, pues yo no quiero que aguantes, que te quiten los putazos.
Sí, huevos, todo.
Entonces, cuando Julio me dijo, papá, quiero que me entrene Don Nacho Beristain, y le dije yo, pero ¿cómo te va a entrenar Nacho Beristain? Si Nacho Beristain siempre te ha tirado chingazos, siempre te ha criticado. Por eso lo quiero, papá, dice, porque a él sí le voy a hacer caso, dice.
Nacho no me dice lo que quiero escuchar. Si hago algo mal, me lo dice. Si llego tarde, me lo dice. Entonces, eso es lo que me gusta de él.
Los hábitos se cambian, los hábitos técnicos se cambian, ¿sí o no?
Le está poniendo muchas ganas, me sorprende mucho lo que está haciendo. Y creo fervientemente que a veces, o casi siempre, no gana el mejor boxeador, sino el que tiene más determinación.
And in training for Canelo, his boxer has looked to prove he has an abundance of determination against an opponent who's taken his father's one-time mantle as Mexico's best.
Desde hace mucho tiempo la gente quiere saber quién gana entre yo y él. Creo que soy el boxeador que puedo representar de mejor manera a mi país, porque soy un peleador que siempre me ha enfrentado con los mejores.
It's a bold assertion, and one Canelo would beg to differ with, based not so much on his superior ring achievements, but his pride in how he got here.
Yo soy un peleador disciplinado que ha llevado su carrera desde abajo, y pues él lo contrario, ¿no? Teniendo el gran apoyo de su padre que no lo supo aprovechar, vengo pues haciendo mi propio camino, mi propio nombre.
The words may be spoken softly, but if you sense an edge beneath them, you're not mistaken.
Do they dislike each other? I believe that's an understatement. These guys cannot stand each other. And it boils down to 6-7 years ago when Chavez Jr. was criticizing Canelo because of who he was facing. He was winning his fights easily. The TV made him that he's not a real fighter.
Si me critica gente, pues es normal, ¿no? Eso es, pero cuando son mis rivales, sí, cuando no me lo dicen de frente, cuando no tienen los pantalones para decírtelo de frente, es cuando le molesta. Él habla muchas cosas, dice muchas cosas de mí. Yo fui creciendo más que él todavía. Entonces, pues ha sido una rivalidad ya de muchos años.
They'll be fighting on Cinco de Mayo weekend at a catchweight of 164.5 pounds, 9.5 pounds higher than Canelo's ever fought.
¿Eh?
And to prepare their 5'9" fighter for his 6'1" opponent, the training tandem of Eddie and Chepo Reynoso are utilizing larger sparring partners. Today, in the ring with Canelo, a 6'2", 185-pound Ukrainian, Vyacheslav Shabransky.
Hi.
Okay, vamos.
La preparación ha sido con sparring de las características parecidas a Chávez.
Chávez es un peleador fuerte que aguanta golpes, que pega.
Pues para un lado, para el otro.
Y enfrentarse a los peleadores mexicanos siempre es difícil.
Ahí va, ya lo soplo.
Aunque voy a subir de peso, siempre tengo que bajar para esa división. Entonces, no es como que va a estar mucho más pesado que yo. Así que me estoy adaptando más que nada con los sparring más pesados que yo.
It's almost symbolic, preparing not just for a larger fighter, but for a bout with a larger meaning.
El orgullo, el honor por esta pelea va por encima más de cualquier cosa, y eso es la gran motivación que nos da. El reto para mí, el enfrentar a Julio, pues es seguir avanzando, seguir haciendo mi historia, seguir haciendo mi historia como peleador.
Es una satisfacción que un mexicano como Saúl esté triunfando, que esté triunfando en el mundo del boxeo, en un mundo tan complicado, tan difícil, tan duro. Entonces, yo creo que es una satisfacción para México y todos los mexicanos.
¡Ay! Bien.
Very nice.
In the prime of his career, it would appear Canelo Alvarez is exactly where he wants to be. Which at long last, looks also to be the case for Julio Cesar Chavez Jr.
Hay veces que pelea uno por pelear, y esta vez es algo más personal. Es algo que va a quedar para la historia.
Yo creo que esta es la pelea donde Julio va a sacar todo su potencial y vamos a tapar muchas bocas. Esta es la pelea donde Julio tiene que demostrar realmente que trae mis genes, que trae mis cojones.
Canelo, prepárate para el 6 de mayo. Te vas a caer. La gente te quiere ver en el suelo. Te van a ver en el suelo. Ahora estás peleando con un peleador de veras. No viejo ni chico.
The paths that they've taken have been different, but it all leads to the same finish line, and that's becoming the very best in Mexican boxing today. We're gonna see a great fight. Put aside the hate they have for each other, because they really, really hate each other. Just the fact that they're both Mexican, and the fact that there's so much pride involved, there's not one fight that I can remember where you have two Mexicans and they give us a dull fight. It's impossible.
Vamos, vamos, vamos.
The most fundamental value of a tradition is all that it connects. People. Places. And perhaps most of all, time. In the modern history of Mexico, the idea of fighting as a noble cause has endured as a vestige of the ancient past, capturing the imagination of every generation that emerges, the hope of every young puncher who walks into a gym. In this land, if you decide you want to be a fighter, you become part of something bigger than yourself. Willing to put everything at risk. Your body. Your pride. Your name. For the slim chance to be remembered forever. On May 6th, Mexico's most celebrated boxers of the moment enter the ring to square off against one another. They'll be fighting to win, yes, but also to give themselves over once again to this singular, sacred, and everlasting tradition. Don't miss the live fight, Canelo Alvarez versus Julio Cesar Chavez Jr., Saturday, May 6th on HBO pay-per-view. Plus, 1 week earlier, April 29th, on HBO, it's the heavyweight championship bout between Anthony Joshua and Vladimir Klitschko. This has been a presentation of HBO Sports.